ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वती व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीरये नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवतीरुत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिके। कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। ॐ अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम्। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सागरजातं सहगण रघुनाथानितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखानितं च। नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वतीदेवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे वंशकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः। हरे कृष्णा। सो टुडे हार्टली वेलकम ऑल द असेंबल्ड वैष्णवस एंड वैष्णवीस फॉर टुडेस दिस मॉर्निंग श्रीमद् भागवतम क्लास इन द होली लैंड ऑफ श्री वृंदावन धाम। वी आर रीडिंग कैंटो 8 चैप्टर 23 एंटाइटल्ड द डेमिगॉड्स रीगेन द हेवनली प्लैनेट्स टेक्स्ट 7। प्लीज रिसाइट आफ्टर मी। यत् पाद पद्म मकरंद निषेवनेन ब्रह्मादय शरणदा स्नुबते विभूति कस्माद् वयम् कुश्रुतया खलयो नयस्ते दाक्षिण्य दृष्टि पदवीं भवत प्रणीता यत् ऑफ हुम पाद पद्म ऑफ द लोटस फ्लावर ऑफ द फीट makaranda of the honey, nisevanena, by tasting the sweetness of rendering service. Brahma adayaha, great personalities like Lord Brahma, saranada, O my Lord, supreme shelter of everyone, asnubate, enjoy, vibhuti, benedictions given by you, kasmad, how, vayam, we, kusritayaha, all the rogues and thieves, khalayonaya, born of an envious dynasty, namely that of the demons, te, those asuras, dakshinya drishti padabim, the position bestowed by the merciful glance, bhavata, of your lordship, pranitaha, have achieved. Translation. O supreme shelter of everyone, great personalities like Brahma, enjoy their perfection simply by tasting the honey of rendering service at your lotus feet. But as for us who are all rogues and devotees, born of an envious family of demons, how have we received your mercy? It has been possible only because your mercy is causeless. So Prahlad Maharaj is saying this verse. Do you think that Prahlad Maharaj is a devotee and rogues? Such kind of humility he is exhibiting, that we are all rogues and devotees. There is no purport here, we will read the next verse. Chitram tabehitam ahomito yoga maya lila visrista bhuvanasya visaradasya sarvatmana samadraso visama svabhava bhakto bhakta priyo yadasi kalpataru svabhava. Translation and purport by Divine Grace Srila Prabhupada. O my Lord, your pastimes are all wonderfully performed by your inconceivable spiritual energy. And by her perverted reflection, the material energy, you have created all the universes as the super soul of all living entities. You are aware of everything and therefore you are certainly equal towards everyone. Nonetheless, you favor your devotees. This is not partiality. However, for your characteristic is just like that of a desire tree, which yields means produce, everything according to one's desire. Purport. The Lord says in Bhagavad Gita 9:29, Samoham sarva bhutesu name dvesyasti na priya ye bhajanti tumam bhaktya maite tesu chapyaham. I envy no one, nor am I partial to anyone. I am equal to all. But whoever renders service unto me in devotion is a friend, is in me, and I am also a friend to him. So your best friend, Krishna Balaram. The Supreme Personality of Godhead is certainly equal towards all living entities. But a devotee who fully surrenders at the lotus feet of the Lord is different from a non-devotee. In other words, everyone can take shelter at the lotus feet of the Lord to enjoy equal benedictions from the Lord. But non-devotees do not do so, and therefore they suffer the consequences created by the material energy. We can understand this fact by a simple example. The king or government is equal to all the citizens. How Lord is equal to everyone is giving one example. Therefore, if a citizen is capable of receiving special favors from the government, is offered such favor, this doesn't mean that the government is partial. One who knows how to receive favors from the authority can receive them. But one who doesn't neglect these favors doesn't receive them. So the Lord is equal for to make us understand, Prabhupada gives the example of a government. This example can easily understand by us at least nowadays, as we see that the present government, Indian government, is giving so much favors to the citizens, like Pradhan Mantri Dhan Jan Yojana, Ujala, Ayushman Bharat, so many schemes he is launching, like that. So he, Prabhupada is saying that government is offered such favor, that doesn't mean that government is partial. But there are two classes of men, demons and the demigods. The demigods are fully aware of the Supreme Lord's position and therefore they are obedient to him. But even if demons know about the supremacy of the Lord, they purposefully defy his authority. Like in a city, in a country also, there are some people who doesn't follow the government rules. So they are like considered as criminals. Therefore, the Lord makes distinction according to the mentality of the living being. But otherwise, he is equal to everyone. And another example he is giving, like a desire tree, Kalpavruksha. The Lord fulfills the desire of one who takes shelter of him. But one who doesn't take shelter of such shelter is distinct from the surrender soul. One who takes shelter at the lotus feet of the Lord is favored by the Lord, regardless of whether such a person is a demon or demigod or anyone else for that matter. So here Prahlad Maharaj is praying. As the episode is going on, Bali Maharaj went to Sutal Loka. Lord gave him the special favor, which apparently looks a punishment, but it was a special favor. And after that, Prahlad Maharaj is praying to the Lord, the grandfather of Bali Maharaj, and he is praying, reciting these two verses, especially saying that how he is merciful towards anyone birds or beast or human or demigods or demons, whoever takes shelter of Lord gives favors them. And this verse is quoted, samoham sarva bhuteshu name dvesyasti na priya. So commenting on this verse, Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur wonderfully writes, I would just like to read and explain some of his points. So while the acharyas have this speciality, while giving commentary, they give commentary in such a way as if some question answer is going on. They will raise a question and they themselves will answer that. This is the unique way of giving commentary. When you read commentary, you will understand how they write. Now, on this verse, Chakravarti Pad writes, not only have you shown mercy upon us like demons, Prahlad Maharaj Singh, or demons, like rogues and thieves and debauchees, he is humbly saying, but you show such mercy to anyone, whoever he may be. This is your spell. Anyone, not just devotees or demons. Anyone. So for that, one nice verse is there, how the Lord is shows his mercy to anyone and everyone, for that matter, whoever takes shelter of him. And doesn't require any pre-qualification, prerequisite to achieve the mercy of the Lord. The verse is that vyadhasya acharanam dhruvasya chavayo vidyagajendrasya ka. He's saying that vyadhasya acharanam, there was a hunter. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, read, no? He would kill the animal, not fully kill, but half kill. And what qualification he had? He was a murderer and hunter. But just see, he became a great devotee. So if you say that one should have proper etiquette, acharan, of course we should have. But the hunter didn't have any etiquette, any acharan. Vyadhasya acharanam. And someone may say that, oh, I am a small child, I cannot do bhakti. When I'll grown up, I'll become older, I'll become young, and then I'll practice bhakti. Dhruvasya chavayo. Dhruva Maharaj was not a 25-year young man. Dhruva Maharaj was just only 5-year boy. So he could get the mercy of Lord, he could achieve the mercy of Lord. Dhruvasya chavayo. Vidya gajendrasya ka. Elephant didn't have a master's degree from the Ohio University. The Gajendra didn't have a PhD degree from any or from Varanasi. He was an elephant. An elephant is considered as an animal of tamogun. But you see how he could get the mercy of the Lord. At last, the last verse of how he recited that. Santas sarasiru valena grihita artho drishtva garun mati harinkha upat chakram. And then says, Narayana akhila guru bhagavan namaste. He takes one lotus flower and offers to the Lord. So, because in the life of King Indradumna, he had performed bhakti, he had recited this stuti. Therefore, in the Gajendra body, he could recite the whole Gajendra stuti. So, it is required that it's as a matter of practice we should recite these stutis and remember these verses, or at least chant Hare Krishna constantly, so that if not at all in this life, we may make it in the next life, because we have done in the past life, just like the Gajendra had done in his past life. So what education Gajendra had, he could achieve the Lord. Vyadhasya charanam dhruvasya chavayo vidya gajendrasya ka kubjamyam kimunarupadhikam. One may say that I am not so beautiful, I am ugly, I am black, I can't practice bhakti, I can't achieve Lord. Lord can't give us mercy. The Kubja was not a beautiful Miss Mathura. Kubja was a hunchback lady. You know, on her back there was a hunchback. She was completely ugly. And no one liked that such a hunchback lady. And she achieved the mercy of the Lord. You know that story in the grand road of Mathura, maybe Holy Gate, whatever maybe. Krishna gave mercy to Kubja and she became a devotee. Kubjayam kim rupadhikam vyadhasya acharanam dhruvasya chavayo vidya gajendrasya kya kubjayam kim num rupadhikam sudamno kim no dhanam. Sudama was a poverty stricken, a pauper. You can say, in today's word, bankrupt. no single penny was not there. He was a beggar. And he got the mercy of the Lord. So even a poor person can become a devotee. And then he says that, Vansha ko vidurasya yadupate. Vidura was the son of a dasi. You know that story, the Dhritarashtra, Pandu and Vidura. Vidura was a son of Dasi. What kind of vansa he had? And you see the kind of devotion Vidura had. Duryodhan ko meva tyago sag Viduru ghar khayo. Aise prem pujari bolo Radhe Shyam Shyam Shyam. Such a wonderful bhajan. Lord didn't go to Duryodhan to eat chappan bhog. And he went to Vidura to eat sag bhaja. Sag bhaji, spinach. And this is the Vidura's fortune. Ugrasya king paurushe. Ugrasen, what paurusha, because Ugrasen was not even the king, his son only, Kansa, put him in the prison. But when Krishna killed Kansa, actually in one sense Krishna was supposed to be the king of Mathura. And he gave the kingdom to Ugrasen, just because he was the nana of Krishna. He was a devotee of Lord Krishna. What paurusha he had, he didn't have anything, and he got the kingdom and he became a devotee. He got the mercy of the Lord. So by no material consideration can obstruct someone to become a devotee or to achieve the mercy of the Lord. Ugly, poor, or no paurusha, or any, no conditions can become a hidden hindrance. At last he said that Bhaktya tushyati kevala nachaguneir bhakti priya madhava. So Lord Krishna, Madhava, becomes pleased by the qualities, by the devotion, not the qualities. Bhaktya tushyati kevala nachaguneir. It's not that one should have this all these qualities, then only Lord becomes pleased. All simple devotion. So Prahlad Maharaj is saying that only. So Lord favors, Lord's favoritism towards devotees. And Lord, how much Lord loves his devotees. He says that I don't love to my wife, to my brother, to my son, to my immediate expansion. Na tathame priyatama. I am not so much dear. Atma yoni na sankara. Atma yoni means Brahma. I am not so dear to Lord Brahma. Na sankara, not even Lord Shiva, Bholenath. I am not so dear to him. Na sankarsana, not my own elder brother. Na Sri, who doesn't like his own wife? Tell me. They keep them in their heart. And Lord is also keeping Lakshmi ji in the heart. And he is saying, na Sri, not even Lakshmi is so dear to me. Then who is dear to him? He is telling this verse to Uddhava. Naivatma, are forget about Lakshmi or Shankar. I myself is not dear to me. Myself is not so much dear. Naivatmana cha yatha bhavan. Bhavan, O Uddhava, devotees like you, is so dear to me. I forget everything. Just see how Lord loves his devotees. So here, Prahlad Maharaj is saying that only, that you always take side of devotees. You always give favor to the devotee. Like we hear from Puthu Maharaj also, when Puthu Maharaj is praying to the Lord, that, O Lord, please put us at your lotus feet so that we want to serve your lotus feet. Then he himself is saying, no, how can you say that we want to serve your lotus feet? The lotus feet is the property of Mahalakshmi. And there will be a comeback, there will be competition between Mahalakshmi and the devotees. Devotee want that we want the service of lotus feet. And Lakshmi is saying, no, you can go. This is my property. I have acquired this, the service of lotus feet of Lord. If such competition will happen, O my Lord, you will not take side of your wife. You will take side of us. So who is saying this? Prithu Maharaj. Just imagine how Lord loves his devotees so much. So here saying that Samoham Sarva Bhutesu. Prabhupada has quoted this verse. And to this verse, the purport is so wonderful. I just want to read some points. How Lord is equal to everyone, at the same time, he takes side of his devotees. Purport of 9.29. Samoham Sarva Bhutesu. One may question here that if Krishna is equal to everyone, no one is a special friend. then why does he take a special interest in devotees who are always engaged in transcendental service? But this is not discrimination, it's natural. How it is natural? One example. Any man in this material world may be very charitably disposed, but if his son will come and, "Papa, can you give me some money?" "Oh, my whole property is for you, my dear son. I may give some thousands of donations to Krishna Balaram Mandir or to someone. But for son, for own son, the father's property is for his own son." So this example Prabhupada quotes. So in the same way, I heard him saying that, in the same way, Lord is also favors, gives favor to his devotees. And then he gives another example in this, to this purport. Prabhupada is saying that, you see, there is a, suppose 24 carat ring, golden ring, so precious, 24 carat, so looks so effulgent, and that golden ring is there. On top of that, there is a Kohinoor Hira, diamond, on that ring. Imagine a ring, and on that ring, there is a diamond. So the ring is, the diamond is anyway, it's so beautiful and so effulgent, and this is on the ring, so ring also becomes more effulgent and beautiful, effulgent. So Prabhupada gives this example comparing to the devotees and the Lord. Devotees, in their original swarupa, being a devotee, are like this golden ring, 24 carat, very effulgent. And Lord is like that Kohinoor Hira, diamond. And imagine this combination. If someone is a devotee and is serving the Lord, it's like this gold ring, and then Lord Krishna Balaram, Radhesham, Gornita is like Hira, diamonds, and the combination of ring and diamond is so beautiful, so charming looking. Anyone attracts to that. So this is the combination. So the living entity in his pure state, in the form of a devotee and the Lord, the combination is such. So therefore, although Lord is equal to everyone, he gives oxygen to everyone's nose. Am I right? He gives light to everyone. He gives all the facilities to everyone. But ye bhajanti tumang bhaktya, one who is a devotee, one who is surrendered to him, Lord gives special favor, special mercy to them. So this Prahlad Maharaj is saying, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. The Lord favors to his devotees, but sometimes it's very difficult to understand what kind of favor, what kind of mercy is this. Like here in this case, if someone doesn't read the complete section of Bali Maharaj, he will definitely fall find in the Lord. What kind of favor is this? You see, in the case of Bali Maharaj, he's chastised, he rebuked, he accused, he defamed, he did everything, he snatched, and he pushed down to the Sutal Lok. So it is like a heavy punishment. Do you think that this is the special favor of the Lord? But it is the favor of the Lord, as we know. What Bali Maharaj got is more than Indra. And the next Manvantara, I think, he will be Indra. Isn't it? So this is the favor of the Lord. So generally, people or even devotees can't understand why these difficulties come to us. Why this reverse comes to us. Why this challenging in our spiritual life or even in our material life. I am a devotee, I am a 16 rounder devotee, I am initiated devotee, I am a full-time devotee. Still the difficulties, so much test, challenges. What kind of favor is this? What kind of mercy is this? Inconceivable. It's really very difficult to understand. So it's upon Lord how He wants to favor or shower mercy to His devotees. It's completely depend upon Lord by giving prosperity or poverty. By giving prosperity or poverty. So it's all depends upon the Lord. But the real devotee is one, he will never leave devotional service at any cost. Dukhesu anudvignamana sukhesu vigata spruha vitaraga bhaya krodha sthitadhir muni. So this is the quality of devotee. In any case, devotee will not give up the devotional service. Like Bali Maharaj. Bali Maharaj never gave up the devotional service. So, to understand this point, that how Lord favors to someone, we will discuss a wonderful example from Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. When I read the pastime, it really difficult to understand how Lord favors. One is on threshold of death, marne wala hai, just about to die. And you see, this is the favor of the Lord. This pastime comes in this Chaitanya Charitamrita Anta Lila chapter 9. One time Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was there in Gambhira with his all transcendental associates. A group of devotees came running, rushed towards Lord. And they are shouting and howling and yelling, telling the, giving information to the Lord. Oh Lord, oh Lord, please do something. There is a greatest disaster happened in the life of Gopinath Patnaik. And Lord was, what happened? Calm down, cool down. What happened, tell. And then the devotee said that the son of King Pratap Rudra, he caught Gopinath Patnaik and is giving it the punishment. The punishment is changa. There are serpent swords are there underneath. And the person will be hang on the top. There is also another sword. And then slowly they will drop him. And his body will fall on the bed of roses. No. Bed of swords, serpent swords. And imagine what will happen. Just like you grind dhaniya pata ka chutney, ya pudina ka chutney, what will happen? In the same way, the body will crush and will become like chutney, pieces. Such kind of punishment. And the Lord was surprised. Why? What happened to this? Gopinath Patnaik. And please remember, my dear devotees, Gopinath Patnaik was the brother of Ramananda Roy and the son of Bhavananda Roy. And they are very close associate of the Lord. Very close. All are initiated devotee. Or say pure devotee. And specially favored by Lord Chaitanya. You see, in the case of devotee, what disaster happens. Some may think that Hare Krishna ban jayenge to koi dukh nahi aayega. If we become devotee, then nothing will happen. You see, eternal associate of the Lord, how this disaster happens and how Lord reciprocates, how, in which way. So they said, oh Lord, you are the supreme controller, you are the supreme master, you can do anything and everything. Please protect your devotee. Gopinath Patnaik is on changa. He is just about to die. And Lord inquired, tell, what happened? The whole story you tell. And then the devotees told that Gopinath Patnaik was a treasurer of some province, some area. Everything is detailed there, I am just paraphrasing. The whole chapter is this pastime. And he would collect tax, say GST. He would collect tax from the citizens. And he is supposed to give to the king Pratap Rudra. But he collected the tax. He didn't give the whole amount. He kept for himself. And the king noticed. And the king Pratap Rudra asked. At this moment, please understand carefully, Pratap Rudra was also a devotee. everyone is devotee. By that time, everyone is devotee. The Pratapudra asked, so you didn't pay the tax? So how will you pay? Then Gopinath Patnaik said that, oh my dear king, please forgive me. I will pay slowly. I will sell my properties one after another, and then slowly I will repay. At the same time, I have some 10-12 horses are there, and they are good quality horses, maybe from Iran or some other place. So I can ready to sell them, you can take them. So Pratapudra was a very busy king. His capital was in Katak, but his quarter was in Puri. Like king would have many quarters, no? He was staying in Katak, but he had a palace in Puri also. He would come frequently to see Lord Jagannath, take darshan of Lord, and meet Lord Chaitanya also, and Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, and Kashi Mishra, his priest. So Pratapudra said that, okay, he sent his son, whose name was Purushottam. Actually, his father was also Purushottam. Do you remember in the Odisha history? The king Purushottam Dev's, whose wife was Padmavati, his son is Pratapudra. And again, Pratapudra had many sons. One son was Purushottam. So he sent his son that, okay, take some ministers and collect the taxes. And this Purushottam, this son, had a bad habit. You know what is the bad habit? What is that? He would nod his head like a horse. In every sentence he would say like that. Suppose he is asking Gopinath Patnaik to, Gopinath, can you give tax to me? Like, he would nod his head like a horse. He had this habit. Some person have this habit, na? Various kinds of habit. I not exhibit all those because this is a Bhagavatam class. You can understand. There's many devotees. Some have eye blinks like this. some say in every half of the sentence like this. They'll not have any problem in the throat, but there is a kind of mental habits. So in that way, so Gopi, this son had also habit of nodding the head and looking upwards. He will not see the straight forward. If some, he will talk someone, then he will see the up and down like this, he would say. So he came to Gopinath Patnaik and he gave the very lower price to these horses, and the horses are very expensive, and Gopinath Patnaik didn't agree with that. And out of mazak mein, out of his fun, and because he had a good relation with Pratapudra, he said if I say something then he will not mind. But mazak bhi bahut serious, it became a serious, that joke in a funny way he was teasing, but it became serious, and so much so that his life is about to end. He said, Gopinath Patnaik said, my horses are so wonderful, so good looking, so nice, and you are giving so much low price. My horses are quite expensive, and my horses, they don't nod head like you in every sentence like this. They are better than you. That means in one sense he is saying that you are worse than my horse. And that was the, if someone is teasing, then definitely he will become disturbed. And he went to his father and he said all the bluff, all the left and right, all the, he mixed some mirch masala. This Gopinath, this fellow is a rascal fellow, he is a squander, he is a cheater. He said he will not give anything. And then father said, okay, if you want to collect the tax, you can do. He didn't say some particular way. Anyway, if you want to collect, like Sam, Dan, Dand, Bhed, like this. So he got the chance, the son. And he went and he caught Gopinath Patnaik immediately and went to that place where about to hang, and made that punishment which is known as Changa in Chaitanya Charitamrita. and 1, 2, 3, 4 time 4 different groups of devotees should rush to Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu, please protect, please protect. Baninath Patnaik is also arrested. The brother of Gopinath Patnaik. Baninath Patnaik, because the son of Pratap Rudra became so angry that I will punish the whole family. If one commits a mistake, the whole family will get the punishment. Unless until he gets the 2 lakh kaudi, you know kaudi. In those days they would have kaudi. Anyone has seen kaudi in old days? Kaudi. So those amounts he would give. He should give us back. Like that he said. Another group said, rushingly. They rushed to Mahaprabhu and they said that Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu, Gopinath Patnaik is already in Changa. They are about to throw him. And Mahaprabhu said, see, I am a sannyasi. What can I do? Do you think that I should go to Pratap Rudra and Begam, apna Uttari Pasar ke? As a sannyasi, by raising my hand, should I beg Pratap Rudra the 2 lakh amount? Sannyasi is not supposed to beg 2 lakh. But today we can ask for donation. But Mahaprabhu is saying, sannyasi is not supposed to ask 2 lakh, only few amounts he can ask. That is the limit, any sannyasi. And I am a sannyasi, why you are unnecessarily disturbing me? All these material subject matters you are reporting me. What can I do? I can't do anything. And then Swarup Damodar, all the devotees, they plead to the Lord. Oh my Lord, oh Gauranga, you are Patita Pavan. And if you say like this, the Ramanandra is your devotee, Bhavanandra is your devotee, the whole family is your devotee, they are initiated devotee, they are whole surrendered devotee, and you are saying that you are becoming indifferent. It's completely injustice. Now see, the devotees are praying. The Swarup Damodar and other devotees are praying on behalf of Gopinath Patnaik. You cannot become indifferent. You please do something. You are supremely powerful. You can do anything and everything. Mahaprabhu said, what are you saying? I am a sannyasi. I am not a god that I can do anything and everything. If you repeatedly tell me, I will not stay here. I can leave this place. But anyway, if you are saying that something should be happened to them, let us pray to Lord Jagannath. And all the devotees of Mahaprabhu knew who is the moving Jagannath. Who is that? Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki. He was the moving Jagannath. And moving Jagannath is saying that, mobile Jagannath, that let us pray to Lord Jagannath. If Jagannath is merciful, then he can do some mystery. So all they started praying Jagannath. Just see the power of praying. My dear devotees, have faith on Chaitanya Charitamrita. As soon as the devotees prayed to Lord Jagannath and they knew within their heart that we are praying to Lord Jagannath, but this Jagannath who is in front of us, Sannyasi Thakur, he can do everything. As soon as they prayed to Lord Jagannath, the Harichandan, one of the minister of Pratap Rudra, he rushed to the Pratap Rudra and he said, my dear king, do you know what's happening? Your son is putting Gopinath Patnaik in Changa and he's about to kill him just to get some 2 lakh of donations. If at all he will be killed, then how will you collect the donation? Wo to mar jayega na. The donation kahan se milega? He will not able to get the donation and that person will be die. So you do something that you ask to collect the donation in some way, at the same time don't kill him. He is your eternal servant. Pratap Rudra was shocked, completely shocked. I never said to kill him. He was not knowing that such kind of incident is happening. He said, immediately go and stop that killing. By the time the devotees are praying to Lord Jagannath, this is the power of Lord Jagannath. And he was just about to thrown to the Changa, Harichandan came and stop! Immediately he raised the voice and raised hand, stop! And they stopped him. That King Pratapudra's order that he should be immediately released. And they released him and they asked, you tell us, how will you repay the 2 lakh amount? And this fellow was completely safe and with a long breath. Imagine he is like second chance, you know, second chance, he is getting the second chance. And he said that, I had said already that I will take the horses and give the best of the prices and I will repay them. That this fellow is not understanding only. He is putting me in changa. And then they released him. At the same time, Baninath Patnaik also, the brother of now the real thing is coming. You know the pastime, but the real lessons are coming, Jasi. Why I am telling this pastime? How do you understand the favor of the Lord? Is this the favor of the Lord? One is going to get killed? And the devotee of the Lord, he is not a karmi. Gopinath Patnaik was not a karmi. He was a devotee. You read Chaitanya Charitamrita, he was a pure devotee of Lord. But sometime, even the devotees commit blunder. Knowingly, unknowingly, mistake. Like apichetesu durachara, na Krishna says, bhajate ma mananya. If a devotee commits a mistake, even that, Lord is so merciful that he gives a token of punishment. Anything happens to us, any reverse happens to us, any disease happens to us, any kind of difficulty comes to us, this is nothing but a token of punishment. And then Lord asked one question to the devotees. Tell me, when they are taking Baninath Patnaik, arresting and taking to the prison, what he was doing? Can anyone guess? He was constantly chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. With one hand, he would chant the rounds, Maha Mantra. Another hand, he would count the mala, just like we count, we have counting beads. After 1000 mantra, he would draw one line on his body. This was his counting beads. Do you understand? He would cut his body, he would draw one line on his body, mark on his body, to count. So when Mahaprabhu heard this, he was completely pleased that Mahaprabhu likes that someone constantly chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, even in the time of disaster or opposite. Then he asked, tell me what Baninath was doing, what Gopinath was doing, one was hanged up. And devotees, do you know what they said? After Gopinath was released, Gopinath said that at the time when they took me and hanged me on the top to throw me on the changa, I was constantly remembering the two divine lotus feet of Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu ki pati tapapana hetu tavo avatara. How can I get killed when you are present in the Puri? I am a devotee of you. Gopinath Patnaik was constantly remembering Lord Chaitanya, Lord Gauranga. And then a whole family, Bhavanand Rai, the whole family came to Mahaprabhu and offered obeisance to them. And Mahaprabhu, they said that, oh dear Mahaprabhu, I know only because of you, and also in bracket Lord Jagannath, only because of you, we all could save. And Pratapudra Maharaj forgave Gopinath Patnaik and he didn't collect the 2 lakh amount also. He increased, promotion ho gaya. He gave promotion to Gopinath Patnaik and he gave increment. And then they all live happily and they were devotee of the Lord. The point is that if the devotee, while practicing bhakti, if sometime he commits mistake or blunder, Lord may give him some token of punishment. And the real devotee is also one who accepts that. but still continue the practice of devotional service. So who knows the mercy, the favor of the Lord, the which way he shows to the devotees in any form, in any type of in any way. There are many ways the favor can come to the Lord. So in this way we have to understand this episode and surrender to the Lord. Hare Krishna. Grantara Srimad Bhagavat Mahapuran ki, Sri Vali Maharaj ki, Sri Prahlad Maharaj ki, Lord Baman Dev ki, Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki, Nitai Gaur Premanande. Hari Hari Bol.